create an advanced or upgraded version of the same thing, and how to create a modified revolution in the already existing thing. And the third thing is very simple. Each and every global system consists of some common insoluble problems. So how to take care of these universal issues which everybody is doing the talk. So one is innovative research in any field. Second is upgraded version of the already existing innovations. Third thing is solutions to universal crises like energy crisis, like mind pollution, like the various problems of health hazards that are existing, challenging diseases are there. So if somebody takes that particular challenge, that person may require more guidelines. So this Cogno technology has two versions. One, it gives a preliminary study for people, those who are interested in handling issues of lack of proper memory, lack of intentional commitment towards education, and lack of rejoicement in learning. So even it starting from the LKG till the college or doctorate level, or even in most upgraded offices and sophisticated service agencies, we are facing these three problems. One is lack of intention, lack of proper desire, or that driving desire is not there. Desire may be there, but driving desire may not be there, number one. And number two, the person may be having some intention, but because of the person's intellectual imbalance, he may not do that. That may result in irritation, headache, inconvenience, and imbalance of the physical or mental status. So these things will be there. So how to get a person's memory, how to reboost a person's performance skill, and how to drive the intention. A person should have these three things. One is the intention to do. Second is the cognitive ability in the form of memory. Third thing is executive ability in the form of upgrading and updating performances. The more they demand, you must also simultaneously grow. So the growth of a person's automated skill commitment should be directly proportional to the market and official demand. So these three things are essential for all people. So it is known as preliminary service. This preliminary service can be given to all students pertaining to different levels. Second thing is sophisticated services of Cogno technology, which can be given only to people, those who are interested in giving innovative exercises, upgrading the innovations, or tasking or taking or tracking the global challenges and finding the solutions. So these two things are there. Very interestedly, we have to do that. And to brief about this Cogno technology, how to do that and what are the exercises. Number one, there is a hierarchy of functioning. We used to say it is, that is neuropsychobio. This is the hierarchy of functioning. And onto neuropsychobio, this is one hierarchy of functioning. They say that consciousness directs your mind, and mind directs the brain, and brain directs the biological functions. This is our knowledge or emotions or anything that you feel, they come under this hierarchy. And there is one question, is there anything independent known as mind apart from brain? This is the number one question. Is there anything independent from the brain which is known as a mind? One, even if the brain is insufficient, according to the neurobiology or neurology or this neurocybernetics or any other multi various dimensions which are emerging and which are existing, which are expected, they unanimously declare that brain is the substratum of all activities. And whatever you feel, like anger, depression, then depreciation, frustration, solitude, mingling with people, happiness, all of these things are not qualitatively present there, but they are distending and determining factors. They are fundamentally found in brain zones and secreted by various other neuronic substances and passed to various bodies by, that is, body particles by neurotransmitters. So it is a neural, neuronic, and neurotransmittery work as per the present neurological sciences. Is there something mind known as? Then the Shastras, even the philosophy, they say that mind is more powerful than brain. Brain is an executive tool for the mind. So if it is so, even though if I am having lack of proper things in brain, can I simulate and stimulate the brain activities as per my desire and direction? There is a question. If my brain is insufficient, if there is a lock, if there is a cleavage, if there is disparity, if there is a blockage, if there is a channel depreciation, if there is any neural network deficiency or any innate problem inside me, can my mind independently has the strength, can it possess the strength so that I can simulate about my own brain without going for a scanning, any encephalography, magnetic or electroencephalography, can I simulate that? Can I envision that? Can I induce my brain to do three things? One is, I already told, there is blood supply. There is energizers, lot of new energizers are induced in brain for having multi-connective nodules to perform. 20,000 networks are there in each and every node. Each and every node network not still will be having thousands of internal networks. So can a mind's urge internally contribute something to the brain to infuse more blood inside? For example, by doing Shirasasana or Dhyana, the efficiency of the mind should make the brain in three things. One, the already existing brain structure revealed. Number two, the already existing brain structure boosted. Number three, already existing debilitated brain structure, it should be ability should be made more. It should be vitalized and invigorated. Is there any possibility? Can a minus become a plus? Can a plus become double plus? Can I understand first through the mind introspective exercise that whether it is plus or minus? These three questions are coming in neuropsychiatry, that is psychoneurology, that deals with mind being a capable tool, having its impact on the neural system. And neuropsychiatry deals with the brain and its impact on the mind connected emotions. So neuropsychiatry deals with brain as a leader and the byproduct of mind and its emotions, whereas psychoneurology that deals with mind as the major tool and which directs this neural network to undergo neural, neuronic and neurotransmittery activities. So it is very much interesting also. Number two, there are innumerable people, those who don't have the cognitive ability, reception and reaction. Cognitive ability, reception and reaction. Who are all they? Number one, a person mentally retarded. Number two, a person who is immature because of his age, I have already told. A person who is having tetraplegia, totally paralyzed. A person in coma. And a person who may be crooked in mentality. A crooked person's mind, because he won't be having the cognitive ability. If a person is crooked, he will not be interested in transformation. He will not be interested. So, a crooked person or a corrupt person, a person in coma, a child which is immature, and the brain or conscious level of plants and other subhuman species, and various other tetraplegia, bipolaris, then various other problems like mental delirium, schizophrenia, etc. For these people, how to induce the mind? Plus or minus, plus be made as double plus, and plus to be minus to be converted into plus. How these things are possibility? This possibility is understood in shastras as well as by parapsychological exercises by means of external induction, by inducing the person from a secondary force on it, which we are going to read later. So that is also possible. So let us come to us. We are normal. That means most of the times we are normal. Nobody is normal. As most of the times we are normal, we are most of the times we are healthy, we are claimed to be healthy. Sometimes we also have the reflections of coma, lunatism, crookedness, immaturity, schizophrenia, all of these resemblances are there. But the only greatness is we are repatriated, or we are re-brought to our senses. We are reclaiming to our originality within few minutes or seconds or hours by an internal compression or by means of a solace or by an external consolation. We are coming back to our original configuration. So everybody is like that. So those who are irretrievable, they are told to be lunatic and other thing. Retrievable lunatics are known as human beings or normal beings. So far as how to develop two things. How to develop two things. For example, I have already told, even it may be BE or MBBS or CE or any examination, intention drive, memory drive and execution drive is a problem. It is a universal problem. Like global warming, whenever we see the books or examination paper, there is a neural warming.